Chef Bonus. I hope you're doing great. Well, this is all about like culinary, right? So the main thing is that this is all about like dessert, like baking terms. So let's start with the four terms. That what I have today is a baked blind. Then we have a baking parchment. Then we have baking powder. Then the last, not the least, is the bake, right? There's a four new terms that I got it from here. It's like, I know your people guys already heard that what it is all about, but gonna give a bit insight, right? Let's go to a bit insight and learn it, what exactly it means. So welcome to my channel, and don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and yes, don't forget to hit the bell icon so you'll get my notification, so you can go ahead and just get us all the terms of what is coming up, right? So first we have is baked blind. So what exactly it means? Let's start. Baked blinds, like a pre-baking, is a pie crust or top shell because the filling is added before the filling is added, right? Baking blind is like a process of baking a pie crust or other pastry without the fillings. Blind baking a pie crust is necessary when it be filled with an unbaked filled, is which case the crust must be full baked. You know what I mean, right? It's all about like when we just make a tart and put in the mold. So we're just going to be put it in the oven, preheated oven. So it just to bake a little bit. It's not about the straight in the raw things and be adding the fillings in between the apple pie, chocolate pie, or white chocolate pie, whatever you're just adding up, your stuff, right? Like kiwi, banana, apple, whatever you want to add it up, is that be fine. But before that, you're gonna be the bake blind. Means it's about not to be empty. The crust may be empty, right? The whole tart will be empty. Preheated oven, go for some 10-15 minutes, depending on the heat, what exactly heat you kept, right? And straight down, bake empty without fillings. That means baked blinds, right? Let's go to the next slide. What we have is baking parchment. Well, this new term is a parchment, but that maybe like a lot of people doesn't know. Because of I did my internship in outside, so a little bit idea. So when I just got to there, so we generally see in India is all about like butter paper, right? Butter paper, that's what I childhood I just heard the same thing, butter paper. So I was like thinking, so that we call as a butter paper, but that is called a baking parchment, also known as a baking paper or parchment paper, as often especially is in US. In US states we say parchment paper, not about butter paper, not even the wax paper, not even second thing is a baking paper, right? They especially say parchment paper. This is like a grease-proof paper that is used in baking. When you're making cookies or some of things, you put the parchment paper so not to get stick to the bottom, right? And not get like a burn. Because when it stick means the whole the heat is like absorbing by the baking that cookie, right? So it will get heat and get big, get ruin the whole cookies. That's why we use the baking parchment paper. So when making cake, it's all things we really use it. So we can easily pull it out from the, I'm gonna say like a mold, right? Parchment paper, baking paper, or baking release paper are like cellulose-based paper that have been treated or coated to make them non-stick. As I said, it's not to be non-stick, right? This is used to be baking a disposable non-stick surface. This should be not be confused with wax paper or waxed paper. So this is all about like simple and quick, right? So baking parchment paper is just a paper, right? But have a different names. People can call as a parchment paper, they can call as a bakery paper, they can say like a wax paper, they can say like non-sticky paper, or you can say like butter paper. Like what we generally say in India, right? Butter paper. That's what I just heard from my whole childhood. So this is you all clear, right? Generally in the US, they say parchment paper, that's baking paper, right? Let's go to the next slide. And what we have is baking powder. Well, this is really a main element, I must say, that you just can't skip it because it's like for proving it. So like whatever you go for the pizza dough, cake, batter, or anything, you require this to make it double size, right? All baking powder contains sodium and just like in a baking soda. So baking powder already contain a little bit of baking soda, but baking powder is also contain two acids. But as soon as the baking powder is strained into a wet dough or batter, the two being a react. There's a two chemical react start, like which is like bubbling of CO2, which is carbon dioxide, and the causing chemical leaving. That is what helps to raise double the batter, right? And that is like releasing the carbon dioxide inside the batter. So what happens is like double, and when we bake it, there is like pops up, like some of holes you can see that is released, like especially in croissant. When you just cut it up, you can see a lot of like, you know, can I say bubbles inside. It's just like a bit raising it, the size, double of the size, right? The same thing that what you're just cooking up. So like a pizza dough, right? We just keep a damp cloth and just keep the rest, the dough, to why? to prove it, right? So that reason is like they are double. So that is the main thing. We just can't skip it. The baking powder is one of the main important elements, right? So you know we clear the baking powder. This is one of the most important thing that you just can't skip this before you're going for the baking process, right? So here we go for the next term that what we have is bay. Let me tell you, it's very quick and sweet. This is gonna be bay. I know, it's like, this is my bay, you might be saying. You must say that it's my bay. Bay, what it mean actually is very simple when you just gonna know about what is exactly bay. The well made in the middle or dry ingredient to receive the liquid ingredient for mixing. That is only called bay. You get it? I hope you get it, because the bay is all about like when we just go for making a dough. So let's go for the pasta dough, right? We keep the flour, we're making a bit aside everything. In the middle, we just keep a bit space to put some liquid so it will not come out from the side, any of things, right? So it's not gonna be runny, so it can be like stay in the middle, and we can slowly adding up the flour, but it's a corner flour. We're just adding in the middle and try to just mix with the liquid. So when we're gonna make a dough, so there's no liquid gonna be come out and runny, and gonna just help make the whole table mess. That is called bay. Making a bay, keeping the liquid inside, so slowly adding the flour in it and make the batter, or you want to make a batter dough out of it, right? That simple word is called bay, right? So quick and simple. So well, I must say that this is the fourth term, that was the last term that what I just said. I hope I'm going to be bring some more new videos coming up with the new terms. So thank you for watching, and do watch, learn, and share, please, so everybody can know about this one. Because want to be a chef, need to be know every single French terms, right? I know some of the points that you already know, but the thing is that sharing is caring. The people who doesn't know about these things, so they can learn from it, right? That is the all simplest I can do that, right? Thank you so much, and I'll come up with a new video, which will be with the new other four terms. It can be a hot kitchen, it can be a baking terms, right? So let's see. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.